Where's that boy? He knows better to keep me waiting on Sunday morning. But I got to be out here. Oh, my goodness, cats and dogs all over the street. Clean up these streets the way they're going on now. I'm going to tell his wife as soon as I see her in church. Man, you see me with my Sunday clothes on. People cleaning the streets and everything.
Gonna see my Sarah. Gonna see my Sarah. Gonna see my Sarah for the sun
William.
Go down.
Rise I've been looking every place for you.
When the big clock chimes,
you're gonna make us late for church.
But Aunt Hagar, I was just playing.
If the open hymn is late starting again, your papa's going to. Now, what's that?
I bought it. Last week, I keep it hid under the porch.
If your papa ever finds out about that thing, that you give it here. If, don't you tell him I knew about this thing. Come on, Larry. Come on, boy. You know how your father is about that opening hymn. Now, you know better than the whole house like that. No, you know, you have more trouble with him when he gets to church. Go ahead. Scoot in there.
Meanwhile, I must admit that I'm very well pleased concerning the results of the late membership drive. Now, on next Tuesday night. Singing this praise for the devil, not the Lord. You insult the Lord right in his own house of worship with such sacrilege. There are only two kinds of music in this world, the devil's and the Lord's.
Amen.
The only kind of music that pleases God is his own music.
Yes, sir.
Sacred music that sings his praises.
Right, right.
Amen.
May the Lord forgive you for turning his sacred song into a tune for evil jigging. William, what's your excuse for being late this morning?
Well, Papa,
I... Charles, it wasn't his fault. It was mine. I couldn't find my hat.
You've kept your hat in the same place, in the same closet for 7 years.
Woman's got a right to change things around. I got tired of it there, so I moved it. And I couldn't find it. That's why we were late.
Well, it's not to happen again. You understand, Will?
Yes, Papa.
It's a bad thing for any church member to be late for worship. For my family, it's unforgivable. I do without. Your whole family does without many things. So there'll be money to educate you when the time comes for your college learning. You are going to be a God-fearing, respected man who is a credit to the Lord, to his people, and to me. I will have it no other way. Do you hear me, Will?
Yes, Papa.
You will go to college. Think of that. Your grandfather was a slave. He had to get his learning without any help. But he became a servant of God and was the first man of his race to be ordained a minister in his state. It will be easier for you than it was for him or for me. And I will be so proud that I...
God no more.
William! William!
I was only listening, Papa.
Charles, you know how he is about music.
Yes, the devil's music. I talk of the Lord and he listens to Satan.
No, I don't listen to him, Papa.
Even while I'm speaking, you
no,
dare...
No, Charles, now he didn't mean it. Now, Charles.
Shut your mouth, woman.
But Charles, you know, he's
shut
been warned.
I bought it. Honest. I worked for it and I saved my pennies. 250 pennies, Papa.
There are only two kind of horns, Gabriel's and the devil's. You saved your pennies. Well, I'll save your soul. Listen to me. I promise that the Lord will wreak his vengeance upon you unless you obey his commands. And I take this oath. I will follow your coffin to the grave before I see you become a maker of music for the devil. Come on, Hagar.
Home from your school in Will Handy. I just don't enjoy singing with anybody playing the organ but you.
I'm glad to be back, Bessie May.
I admit that I wish that Will had received a call to the ministry and had followed in my footsteps, even as I followed in those of my father.
Bessie May, I keep telling him everybody can't be a preacher. And if they were, you wouldn't have nobody to preach to, Reb Handy.
But I'm proud to say that he's been offered a position teaching school as soon as it's open in the fall.
Well, you take Elizabeth on home.
And don't be late for supper.
You're going to have a pretty little daughter-in-law one of these days, Reverend Handy.
It's nice having you home again, Will.
I should be real angry with you. You only wrote to me twice, you know, all last year.
I was kind of busy, but you're not really angry, are you?
No. How can I be? I'm so proud of you, Will. I think it's wonderful about you being offered that teaching job.
But it doesn't pay enough to get married on.
Oh, it will by and by. And it's a respectable profession.
That's very important to you, isn't it?
It is to any woman, Will. If you love somebody, you want to be proud of him, too.
Then let me tell you what I did during vacations. I played with bands. I even traveled with a minstrel show.
Minstrel show? Does your father know?
No, you won't tell him, will you?
No. No, I won't tell him. But a minstrel show.
But you see, it was a wonderful experience. I traveled to lots of places. I even went to San Francisco.
Oh, I can understand you wanting to see the world, Will, but with a minstrel show?
It gave me a chance to play music.
Minstrel show music, dance music. You know how your father feels about that. He's always done what he thought was best for you. Will. Will. You're not not going to throw away all your father's hopes for you, are you?
Don't worry.
Now we
make it $4.
$4 to you.
Good.
$4. Hello, Will.
How's the schoolboy?
Hi, Bullneck.
Finally got back from that loafing, huh?
Got my cornet?
I'll charge you rent money for stealing this home.
I'll take a sarsaparilla, too.
Sarsaparilla? He ain't even a big spending customer.
Crap, now, I'll shoot. I got enough. Look out the way.
Too much noise. Yeah.
Wouldn't be if you was winning.
Is he a musician?
Is he a musician?
Well, I need a five-piece band tonight, and I'm paying
$10. $10? I guess you'll get one together.
Well, then be at the corner of Beale and Jackson tonight at 8 o'clock. It's a political rally. Mr. Bale is running for sheriff.
Oh, yeah, Bale, you know, that's a reform guy. He's gonna reform everything.
Well, maybe you could make up a little song, sort of tell the people what kind of a sheriff Mr. Bale would be.
Yeah, that's all he does, mister. Make up songs and drink that sarsaparilla.
To be the sheriff, there's just one man you should elect. Man you should respect.
You something like that?
Yeah.
Do not fail to vote for honest John Bale.
Cleaner, better Memphis, for justice without tyranny, vote for John Bale for sheriff. I thank you.
First money I made in a week.
Boy, I love this long green lettuce.
Elizabeth, did you hear that song? I wrote it.
How do you think your father would feel, Will, if he saw you playing on a street corner?
I guess he'd like it.
Did you see about that teaching job yet?
There's plenty of time for that.
School opens in 2 weeks.
I'm thinking about it.
Well, Henny, I don't think you want to teach school. I think you'd rather stand on a street corner and play the cornet.
Elizabeth, don't go getting mad.
Well, how do you expect me to feel, Will? You just made it pretty plain that you don't want a steady, respectable job.
There aren't any real steady jobs for musicians.
No, and there never will be, because there's nothing respectable about being a musician.
Elizabeth.
Hey, Will. Are you married to her?
No.
The way she talks, that's the way my wife talks to me.
Say, fellas, I got an idea. Why don't we go to the Big Rooster and play for throwing money?
That's right. Yeah.
Let's go.
Got nothing else to do tonight.
Ain't got no friend, nowhere, Lord. Ain't got no friend. Lord, all by myself, no one to
care. That was very nice, baby.
Yeah. So how come we don't have any people?
Low, boys.
Man, we hit the jackpot.
Close up now, Blake.
Who's running this place, you or me? No business anyway. Closing time, folks. Sorry, boys. We'll be closing up for tonight.
Relax. I invited them. What were you playing? I never heard it before.
Oh, he just wrote it.
Oh, a songwriter. Got any others?
There's one I wrote today.
Will's always writing songs.
Does it have lyrics? Play this for me. And remember now, chantez les bars.
Chantez les bars? What does that mean?
It's Creole. It means sing 'em low.
Hey, Gogo.
Shut up. Well, go on.
The sheriff, there's just one man you should elect. You see, the sheriff must be a man you all respect.
What's going on around here?
If I'm ever going to get where I want to go, I need good songs, and this is a real good one.
Do not fail to vote for honest John Bale.
All right, that's enough. Hire them.
I don't need a band. If you want the song, I'll buy it for you. I'll give you $10 for it. All right, 20.
Thanks, but I'm gonna try and get this one published.
He's crazy.
Hire him and the band.
We already got a piano player. I'm not having a band in here.
You're not gonna have a singer in here either.
You and your boys want a steady job playing in here?
You mean steady, like every night?
Yes, every night. I'll pay you $2 apiece.
You done hired yourself a band, mister. How about it, Will?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I made the offer, Gogo. If he doesn't want it, sure not my fault.
He wants it.
Well, you see, my father...
You need a singer who can sing your songs better than anyone else. Now, that Vale song, with different words, it could be a good song.
Different words?
Mm-hmm. Who cares about Vale? You could do all your work here. I can come down during the day and sing your songs for you. We could work here during the day together, undisturbed. You might turn out to be the best songwriter in the whole country. You'd like that, wouldn't you? Now let's hear that song again.
To be the sheriff, there's just one man you should elect. You see, the sheriff must be a man you all respect. So do not fail to vote for honest John Bale. No, do not fail to vote for honest John Bale. I know the Yellow Dog District like a book. Indeed, I know the route that rider took. Every cross town, Bayouburg and Bar, way down where the Southern cross the Dove. Every kitchen there is a cabaret. Down there the boll weevil works while the farmers play. This Yellow Dog blues the livelong day. Dear Zoo, your easy timer struck this burg today on a southbound rattler side door Pullman car. Seen him here, then he was on the hog. Easy timer gotta stay away, so he had to vamp it, but the hike ain't far. He's gone where the Southern cross the Yellow Dog. He's gone where the Southern cross the Yellow Dog. Yes, he's gone where the Southern cross the Yellow Dog.
Gentlemen, that was Yellow Dog Blues, written by our up-and-coming composer, W.C. Handy.
You didn't answer me. What are you doing that keeps you out so late every night?
Oh, you know.
No, I don't. And that's why I'm asking. And your papa's due to start asking soon, too.
Look, I'm a grown man now. I can stay out late if I want to. I'm not getting in trouble or anything.
There's trouble? And there's trouble. The boy's up to something.
Love, oh, love, oh, careless love.
What's that?
Oh, a song I wrote called Careless Love.
Careless Love?
Yeah.
Now, what kind of love is that?
William Handy?
Yes, sir.
The William Handy who wrote Yellow Dog Blues? My name is Mawson. May I come in?
How do you do?
I do.
Now, Handy, I'm an attorney. I represent a music publishing firm that's authorized me to pay you $50 for that song.
$50?
That's our usual payment for music rights. Now, if you will sign right here, I'll pay you the money now.
Is this all there is to it?
That's all. My client doesn't believe in wasting time. 30, 40, 50. There you are. That's right. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
$50, Aunt Hagar, and this is just the beginning.
Yeah, but Will, put me down. Now, Will, stop it. Stop it, Will. Put me down, Will.
I'm going to go right out and buy you a present. What do you want?
I don't want you to buy me anything. Now, don't buy me anything.
Why?
Will, don't burden me with anything I can't explain to your papa.
But when he finds out how much money I can make writing songs.
Will, you worry about when he finds out. Now, listen, honey, I know you love music, but you think about that careless love. And don't you get careless.
Thought I told you to go get the car.
It's in the alley.
You're gone sweet on that man.
The only thing I've gone sweet on is the music he writes.
But baby, we told him we'd be there on time.
I like that. You're a big talent, Will. Your music is going to make us both famous. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
I don't know. I never thought about it.
That's right. Don't. I can do enough thinking about it for both of us.
Say, Gogo, where are you from?
St. Louis. Ever been there? Lots of pretty girls in St. Louis.
They lost one when you went away.
If I were a little bird, I'd fly from tree to tree. I'd build my nest way up in the air, where the bad girls could not bother me.
Want to try one?
For you to fall in love with. I'll tell you why. Because Gogo can only love Gogo, and I wouldn't want you to get hurt. I'll tell you something else. You could never love anyone as much as you love your music. That's why we're so good for each other. Because with your songs and the way I sing them,
You're going to have fame, whether you want it or not.
The preacher's son.
I would rather have been told that you were dead than to be told that you work in that place.
But Pop is not like that, though.
No? Is the Big Rooster a house of worship for the Lord?
No.
No! I know what it is. Every decent citizen in Memphis knows what it is, and you know, too. And the shocking thing is that there is where you have chosen to go.
All I do is write and play music there.
But what kind of music, Will? Music for those that worship the devil.
Papa, I don't know anything about worshiping the devil. You know that.
You will never again set foot in that place. You've done absolutely nothing about that teaching job. Why?
I just can't see myself as a teacher.
You will take that job.
But, Papa...
You will do as I say or you will leave my house.
Papa, won't you try to understand? The music I play is the music of our people. It's not mine, it's theirs. All of our people evil because they sing other songs besides hymns. I was born with this music in me.
You will make your choice.
Downstairs. She wants to see you.
Be right back. Elizabeth. What are you doing here?
I didn't know where else to find you.
I rented a room over on Beale Street. I've been so lonesome for you, Elizabeth.
I have too, Will. I missed you. Your Aunt Hagar told me about what happened at home. I'm sorry about that, Will.
I am too. I've done nothing the last 2 weeks but try to figure out some way to make it up with Papa.
Maybe if you stop working in this place.
Elizabeth, don't lecture me. You know one of the big reasons I'm staying here? This is the only place I can find where people don't think I'm being sinful or evil for playing the music I feel.
Do you think these people are better judges than your father, Will? He's a minister. He knows what's right and what's wrong.
About a lot of things, yes, but try and understand how important it is for me to do what I'm doing. I can't be happy doing anything else.
Your father's sermon on Sunday was about that. He said that if people only did the things in this world that made them happy, nothing at all would get done but the sinful things.
You mean if a man is happy doing anything, there must be something sinful about it?
No. That's not true. He'd have been very happy if you'd taken that teaching job.
Yeah. Everybody else but me.
Sorry I'm late, honey. I'm ready to work if you are.
She didn't mean anything. That's just Gogo. She's a singer.
Now I see what's really holding you here. Take it back.
There's nothing between her and me,
Take
Elizabeth.
It back.
I swear it. Elizabeth.
Boys, take a break. Chantez les bas, I like it.
First words you ever said to me.
Another headache? We don't have to work today.
I'll be all right. I feel better if I work one.
What's her name, Will?
Elizabeth.
Your girl?
Used to be.
Yes, W.C. Handy.
I'm Will Handy.
I'm Fred Duckett. Mayrose Music Store. Got a letter here from the Orthophone recording people. They've authorized me to pay you $600 to record your song, Yellow Dog Blues. That is, unless you've already disposed of the recording rights in your publishing contract.
Oh, no, I didn't do that.
Well, then, if you bring that contract around to my store and it's all in order, we'll fix up the proper papers on this deal, eh?
I will. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
See, Will, I told you you were going to become famous.
Gogo. If a company like that is willing to pay so much to record my songs, well, our music can't be so evil, can it?
Evil? Of course not. Whatever gave you that idea?
Mawson, Mawson. Morrison. That's that lawyer's name. I always get those contracts. Morrison. That's him.
All right, let me in on it. Maybe I can smile, too.
Fortune teller told me I was going to make a lot of money.
Good. And maybe you can afford to buy better coffee for this joint.
Maybe I can even afford you.
Hello, Will. Did you get everything settled?
Not yet. I just had a meeting with Mr. Morrison.
Fine man, Mr. Morrison. He's my attorney at law, you know.
I just found that out. He told me you're the one who bought Yellow Dog Blues. I'll need that paper I signed to show Mr. Duckett.
Oh, Mr. Fred Duckett of the Mayrose Music Store? I met him just a little while ago. A fine man to do business with. He paid me $600 without batting an eye.
Paid you?
Who else, baby? I own that song. Will sold it to me. I hereby convey all mechanical rights, including phonograph records and player piano rolls, as well as sheet music, for the sum of $50. So you got all you're gonna get, man. $50. Attacking me. I'll call the law and have you thrown in jail.
You might have to have us all thrown in jail, Blade.
This here's legal. Nobody twisted his arm to make him sign it.
The least you can do is split the money with him.
I didn't get to own this place by splitting with anybody. You know, you got a cheap lesson. Next time, read before you sign.
What's all right, stop it, stop it! What's the matter with you? Customers are coming in. Get on the bandstand and play. Go on, get! You'll write plenty more songs. You'll make more money than Blade's ever heard of. Were you sleeping?
No.
Elizabeth's not out there, if that's who you're looking for.
I wasn't looking for anybody. How's Papa?
He's stubborn as stone, but I know he misses you. We all miss you. Will, are you still at that place, the Big Rooster? Will, why can't you try to please him?
Please him?
Only suggesting. One thing for sure, this way, nobody's happy. Brought your mail along. It's been piling up.
Mighty big pile.
Thought it might be important.
I'm rich. Royalties from the sheet music of Harlem Blues, $9.40.
What is it? $900.
From phonograph records of Careless Love. Do you think this money is evil?
What I think and what your papa think are two different things. Your papa thinks the only true riches are in heaven.
It's nice to have a little pocket money while we're waiting to get there.
Your papa don't make this much money in 2 years.
I wonder.
What?
He'd have to like that.
How are you ever going to explain this to your papa? You're sure too big to hide quick.
I remember her saying once how much she wished we had a piano so there could be music in the house.
Oh, your mama was always wishing for a piano. But your papa could never afford one. She sure loved music, especially church music.
As a child, I asked my mother, is there a morning star? I was answered by my mother, yes, there's a morning star. Just before the dawn, she whispered, a light will appear above, and this light that greets the sunrise, this is the star of love. For this is the morning star that shines above. Yes, this is the morning star. This is the star of love. And then I ask my mother, will I see the morning star? I was answered by my mother, you will see the morning star. It gleams for just one moment in the skies. Then it shines forever after, deep in a mother's eyes. That's when I learned how wise all mothers are. For there in my mother's eyes, I saw the morning star. The love light in her shining bright like a morning star.
He remembered, Charles. She always wanted a piano in the house.
Even though she's gone, I kind of like to believe she knows it's finally here.
Just think of it, Charles. After all these years, he remembered her favorite hymn.
Maybe I love music so much because my mother did.
She loved God's music.
But, Papa, my music can't be all evil if a big company can sell so many records and pay me $900.
William, are you still at that place? No man who earns his living by consorting with trash in a speakeasy is welcome in my house. Neither are his gifts.
Now, Charles.
Never mind. I can't remember ever being able to please you. I guess I never will.
Come in. Do I know you?
You only met me once with Will Handy. My name is Elizabeth.
Oh, the girl in the hallway. What can I do for you, honey?
Will had to move out of his home.
So?
Can't you see that this kind of life is wrong for a man like Will?
No, I can't.
I thought that maybe if you love him, I mean really love him, you want to do what's best for him.
What's best for him or best for you?
I think you're a very bad influence on him.
I think you have things a little backwards, honey. You may be a good judge of women, but you have a lot to learn about Will Handy. He's a big talent, and you don't understand. He's going to be famous one day.
Be famous in places like this?
Famous any place with anyone, except with narrow-minded people who condemn when they don't understand. Come on. Let's see what he has to say about it. Big chance has come. I have an offer from a nightclub in New York. I want you to come with me, Will. Look, I want you to come with me where you can have a chance to make something of yourself in music. You don't want to stay here and be nothing. All right. The train leaves at 6 o'clock. In case you change your mind, I'm taking your songs with me. I hope you're going to be there to hear me sing them.
And the blind man on the corner who sings the Beale Street Blues.
I'm glad you didn't go, Will.
I can't go anyplace other, Elizabeth. I'm going blind.
Right. When did he come home, Aunt Hagar?
Yesterday. Charles brought him. You know, he can't refuse his father.
I just came from his room. His landlady said he moved out. I got in a panic.
We saw an eye, ear, nose, and throat doctor this morning. That's the third. Same thing. They don't know why Will lost his eyesight.
Somebody must be able to help him.
With all their learning, these doctors just don't know. This last doctor said he had a case where a man lost his hearing. No reason for it either. Just went deaf one day. And his wife left him, and his hearing came back.
Well, what's that got to do with Will's eyes, Aunt Hagar?
Well, nothing, child, except maybe... just nothing. Excuse me, Elizabeth. I got to get my watch off the line.
Good to see you home.
Don't feel sorry for me.
Maybe I'm feeling sorry for myself.
Don't feel sorry for anybody. Don't touch me! Sorry. When a thing like this happened, you just can't stand kindness from anybody.
I'm not being kind.
Sorry.
Do you want to go for a walk?
we?
In the church?
I have no right to be here.
Everybody has a right to be here, Will.
Papa said the Lord would punish me. He did.
Will, the Lord forgives, too. That's his business. He gave you your talent.
I didn't use it right.
Then use it in a way you think he meant for it to be used. You could write hymns.
Hymns?
Why don't you try?
Isn't that beautiful?
I keep thinking about what that doctor said. About the man who was deaf until his wife left him. What is it, do you suppose?
What is what?
What's Will afraid to see?
Sisters, that beautiful hymn was written by my son, W.C. Handy.
Papa really liked it, didn't he?
Everybody liked it. It's a beautiful hymn, just beautiful.
I could almost hear a smile in his voice. Was he really smiling at me, Elizabeth?
You talk like you've never seen him smile.
No. Not at me, not often. But I was so anxious for him to like it. He really did, too, didn't he?
Yes, well, your father loved it. I think it made him very happy.
I'm so glad you took me to church that day. It got me back to playing the organ again.
Did hearing her sing make you feel sad?
No, I wasn't even thinking of that. I was thinking of you. How much you mean to me.
how grateful I am to you for so many things.
Well, I love you.
I'm a blind man, Elizabeth. That's enough, John. Don't you ever practice between lessons? You don't want to learn how to play the piano.
That's what I told my mother. My mother told me to give you this quarter.
Going for a walk.
Take the sergeant for gone to the river, and there's a reason why. Because the river's wet and Beale Street's done gone dry.
You don't want to stay here and be nothing.
What's this?
What?
This St. Louis blues.
Oh, a song I wrote once.
Here, wait a minute. Where you running off to? Come back here. Come on over here, honey. Come on, Will. Will, play this for me. Sit down, honey, and play it. Sounds good, Will. My heart around by her apron string. Sound like you wrote that one about your Aunt Hagar. If it wasn't for powder and the store-bought hair. Can you see your Aunt Hagar with store-bought hair? That's fun. Did you write the words, honey? Man of mine, he would not go nowhere. Nowhere. I like this, Will. Got the St. Louis blues, just as blue as I can be.
Devils and the Lords. Two kinds of music. The Devils and the Lords. The Devils and the Lords. The Devils. The Devils. The Devils. Help me, God, please help me.
Will's gone, Reverend Andy. When I got here, he was gone.
Thank you.
maybe by and by. Going to the river, and there's a reason why. Because the river's wet and Beale Street's done gone dry. If I were a little bird, I'd fly from tree to tree. I'd build my nest way up in the air where the bad girls could not bother me. I know the Yellow Dog District like a book. Indeed, I know the route that rider took. Every cross tie, bayou, berg, and bog. Away down where the Southern Cross, the dog. Was answered by my mother, "You will see the morning star. It gleams for just one moment in the skies. Then it shines forever after, deep in a mother's eyes."
May I come in? Don't get frightened. I'm not going to stay. I'm playing St. Louis and decided to stop by. Where's the tall boy?
Will's gone. We thought he was with you.
Didn't you two get married?
No.
What happened?
Right after you left, Will went blind.
Blind?
We didn't know what happened, and nobody, not even the doctors, knew why. And then he got his eyesight back, and we thought everything was going to be all right. He started working with Papa, writing hymns.
Church music. Is that what you had him doing?
He wrote beautiful hymns.
Well?
I don't know. He didn't seem very happy, and a few months ago, he went away.
When are you people going to learn?
I don't understand.
All you people pretending to save Will. For what? From whom? Don't you understand this man has a big talent and a need to express it?
We were only trying to help
him. But you were destroying him instead. That's why he left home. Can't you see that now?
What shall I do?
Look, I came here to tell Will that his music is going to be played by the New York Symphony. They've asked me to do one of his songs.
The New York Symphony? Will's hymns?
No, honey. The St. Louis Blues. Do you really want to help Will?
Yes.
Can you get his father to New York?
I don't know.
Well, you get him there. But don't tell him what's going to be played. I'll try and have Will there. Maybe my agents can find him.
The St. Louis Blues.
Look, you've all tried making him do things your way. It only made him run away from home. Try my way. And remember, honey, unless he's free to love his kind of music, he's not going to be free to love you or anyone else.
Isn't it beautiful? What is it, child?
Reverend Handy, you've been my minister for as long as I can remember now.
Mm-hmm.
And whenever I've had a problem, you've been able to help me.
Of course, child.
I'm not a child, I'm a woman. I'm in love with a man, a minister's son, who went away, who needed help, who maybe was driven away. I only know that I love him so much, I don't care what kind of music he plays or where he plays it.
You don't realize what you're saying.
Yes, I do. It's very plain to me that whether I ever understand this thirst of his or not, I know it can't be evil because he is not evil.
And the Lord hath blinded their eyes that they may not see.
Maybe it was his father and I who were truly blind. He didn't sin against us or God. We sinned against him. Maybe that's why he went blind. Maybe he couldn't stand to see our disapproval. I don't know.
I wonder where he is.
I am sorry, madam, but we are also out.
Well, we are Will Handy's family, and we've come all the way from Memphis just to hear this famous orchestra play our boy's music.
I can't help who you are, madam. There just aren't any seats left.
Please stop pointing at that sign and try to help us. There must be some extra seats in there somewhere.
Just a minute, madam. I'll try one other source.
I'll tell you exactly what has to be done with that number. I'll see you later.
Okay.
I see you made it.
Is Will here?
No, I've tried every musicians' union in the country, but we haven't been able to find him.
I got his family to come.
I'm sorry, madam, but all the agencies are also sold out.
Come on, Charles. This is terrible. We come all the way from Memphis just to hear Will's music and... Elizabeth, I don't know what we're gonna do. That man says he don't care who we are, there are no seats left.
Miss Germaine, this is Will's father, Reverend Charles Handy, and his Aunt Hagar.
We came all the way from Memphis just to hear Will's music, and now we can't get in.
I think I can get you in.
You could?
St. Louis Blues. You told me they were playing his hymns.
St. Louis Blues?
Cheap dance hall.
This is Aeolian Hall, Reverend. No dancing, no drinking. People pay $3.30 a seat just to sit and listen to great music.
Great music? A trashy blues tune?
A famous conductor like Bakalennikov wouldn't play trashy music at a symphony concert.
Why can't you have an open mind about it? I've been telling him just that for years, and he's so prejudiced about jazz
that
I...
Call it prejudice if you like. I will not apologize for it. You and Elizabeth can expose yourselves to it if you want to. I'll wait at the hotel.
That's right, Reverend. Stick to your guns. You stick to them because, after all, prejudice is a time saver.
I beg your pardon?
Well, a busy man like you, you can form an opinion without wasting time bothering about facts. If you still want to hear the St. Louis Blues, it starts at 10:30. You'll be here and the usher will take you backstage.
We'll be there. Come on, Elizabeth. Come on.
And a distinguished looking audience.
Not many undistinguished people can afford 330 a seat.
Be quiet.
But I was telling him about
this. Just be quiet. It's too late. Almost time.
You're about to hear some facts, Reverend.
Ladies and gentlemen, when I announced the programming, the famous St. Louis Blues by W.C. Handy, many people asked me why the symphony orchestra would play the blues. Jazz, or what we call the blues, is the one and only pure art form to originate in America. Other art forms, like opera, paintings, architecture, sculpture, all come to us from Europe. Only in the art of a new folk music is America preeminent. And one man, more than any others, is responsible for that fact, William C. Handy. Last year, on a tour abroad, I conducted St. Louis Blues. And when the audience stood up, I was surprised. Well, they thought we were playing the American national anthem.
Star-Spangled Banner?
No, the St. Louis Blues. Shh.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Germain.
Hate to see the
my baby. He done left this town. Gypsy done told me, don't you wear no black. Yes, she done told me, don't you wear no black. Go to St. Louis, you can win him back. Help me to Cairo, make St. Louis by myself. Get me to Cairo, find my old friend Jeff. Pin myself close to his side. Can be. That man got a heart like a rock cast in the sea. Or else you wouldn't have gone so far from me.
Ladies and gentlemen, the composer, William C. Handy.
Come on, Will, come on. They're waiting for you.
You said this afternoon you couldn't find
me. I did, didn't I?
St. Louis woman with her diamond ring pulls that man around by her apron string. Twant for powder and for store-bought hair. The gal I love would not gone nowhere. Got the St. Louis blues, just as blue as I can be. That gal got a heart like a rock cast in the sea. or else she would not have gone so far from me. I love that gal like a schoolboy loves his pie. Like a Kentucky colonel loves his men and rye. I'll love my baby until the day I die. I'll love my baby till the day I die.